A close family member of yours has been diagnosed with cancer. The doctor says that the cause of this cancer must have come from exposure to a few chemicals found at his workplace. Of the three suspects, two are carcinogens, chemicals that have the ability to cause cancer in living tissue through mutation, the alteration of genetic information that leads to uncontrollable cell growth. But how are you supposed to identify which chemicals were in fact innocent and which were the culprits? Well, have no fear, because biochemical detective Bruce Ames is here. This renowned American biochemist and his fellow colleagues formulated the Ames test during the early 1970s, a revolutionary test designed to screen for mutagenicity associated with specific compounds and chemicals. With the original iteration of the test, Ames used mutated strains of the bacterium Salmonella Typhimurium and saw that by exposing it to mutagens, the bacteria regained the ability to grow. Using this test, they began to detect many known carcinogens such as 2-aminofluorine, benzoapurine, and benzidine, putting them behind bars once and for all. But there was just one problem. Although Ames had a thorough understanding of the bacterial system, there was reasonable doubt that the same method could be extended to the mammalian systems and, by extension, humans. So how did Ames fix it? Well, he still focused on the histidine operon, a particular cluster of genes responsible for synthesizing the amino acid histidine, a crucial amino acid responsible for growth and proliferation of the bacteria. All four mutated strains of Salmonella Typhimurium showed a growth-deficient phenotype, providing a marker for potential mutagenesis. The strain TA1535 contained the histidine mutation HisG46, a missense substitution mutation that alters a single codon within the DNA sequence for the first enzyme needed for histidine biosynthesis, ATP phosphoribosyl transferase. The other three strains of bacteria had mutations that either inserted or deleted a nucleotide, throwing off the protein's reading frame. These are known as frame shift mutations, with the strains TA1536, 1537, and 1538, each having their own mutation in the genes that encode for either the histidinyl aminotransferase enzyme or the histidinyl dehydrogenase enzyme within the histidine operon. Each of these mutagenic strains of Salmonella Typhimurium ultimately crushed the bacteria's ability to make histidine for themselves, and therefore stunting their growth and proliferation. From here, Ames introduces the improvement. To show that the system can be replicated in mammals, he needed to show that the carcinogens could be activated by mammalian metabolism to form potent mutagens. This is how we did it. The mutagenic test was carried out with preparation of the S9 fraction, which contained extract liver homogenate from both rats and humans. From here, he sought to create the S9 mix, which used the S9 fraction, along with all the components necessary to construct the TPNH-dependent microsomal enzyme system. This system generates TPNH, which has been shown to be crucial in activating our carcinogens into mutagens. The S9 mix is then added in combination with the carcinogen to be tested, as well as molten agar, to create the mold on the agar plate. Ames found that the carcinogens he tested had the ability to reverse the histidine frameshift mutations, thus enabling the formation of revertant colonies on the plates. But how? It turns out that because of the circular and flat nature of the carcinogens, this allowed them to intercalate into the DNA. Then, during either replication or repair, they have the ability to either add or delete base pairs within the sequence, thus reversing the deleterious mutation. This enabled the colonies to revert, grow, and form new colonies without outside help provided by the media. Ames also found the opposite to be true. For chemicals that were not mutagenic, because they did not have the ability to change the genetic information, then nothing would happen. Hence, the bacteria stayed handicapped. On top of this, because we had two types of tester strains that came with two types of mutations, we can identify mutagens as either frameshift or point mutagens, depending on which strain they reverse. Another significant finding relates to the fact that if the carcinogen contained a side chain that can covalently react with the DNA, then the potency of the mutagen would increase as well, leading us to believe that some carcinogens have the ability to commit even more vile genetic crimes. Using these results, Ames could support his improvement, showing that it was the exposure to the liver homogenate from both rats and humans that was indeed activating these carcinogens, forming the potent frameshift murder suspects. The results were extremely sensitive, with even the most minute amount of carcinogen being able to form thousands of revertant colonies. Although the results of the experiment were profound in our quest to solve the mystery of mutagenesis, Ames conceded that it probably cannot account for all types of carcinogens, as some do not cause mutations by affecting the genetic code directly, but instead target and destroy their repair machinery. Nevertheless, the improvements made by Ames proved to be monumental in carving out a path that allows us to investigate our mutagenic suspects, ultimately contributing to the goal in prevailing over cancer and the substances that cause it once and for all.